Hello and welcome to another episode of our special series, Beating All Odds. In this series, we are recognizing leaders who are working round the clock, making new plans and ensuring that despite all the challenges that COVID-19 has thrown at us, our economy and business remains as little affected as possible. With me today is one such leader, Mr. Shekhar Banerjee, Chief Client Officer, Wavemaker. Welcome to the show, Shekhar.
Hi, Naziya. Welcome to my new office. My home.
We are all working from home. This is my new office.
Yeah.
So, Shekhar, to begin
but
with,
I get a very good sun, very good view of the sunset from my home. So I'm very lucky about that.
Yeah, you're a rich man. Shekhar, I want to start with the first question. What are the big challenges that this work from home has thrown at you and the lockdown? And how are you ensuring that your peers and your team and everyone remains as enthusiastic or as engaged with the work as possible during working from home?
You know, there are two questions in that. One part is that how do we keep our teams going? And second is about basically the challenges we are facing. Let me first talk about the challenges. Honestly, it's not. When I see across my teams, what we did at WPP and Group M before we went into lockdown, obviously we were learning from the other markets. We picked up the positives on how we can actually manage and plan better for this period. So we had an entire business continuity plan and we did all the tech checks. Let's put it this way. In fact, we were by phase-wise, office-wise, we were doing also testing. Like there was a mandatory managed remote working days for departments and for the entire office. It's quite funny actually. On a Tuesday, we went for a managed remote working from home in Mumbai, and entire Wavemaker office was working from their home. And next day, the news came out of the lockdown, which was quite amusing because we tried and we had to straight jump into the practical one also.
But so you got one more day to prepare yourself.
Yes, let's take it this way. But the good thing is that what we realized is in that week's time of preparation, we roughly got a week to prepare and test all tech checks, everything. Big shout out to our IT team and our talent team to get everything ready before that. So when we moved into our home, we technically didn't face a challenge. It was business as usual. In fact, the best thing was our clients, the way they responded to it and the way they adapted to it also means it's often we say that face-to-face meetings are better. We realize we are face-to-face on our application like Zoom or what we use internally as Microsoft Teams. Those are very effective. We are closing big decisions and big meetings. In fact, I know I was part of a full day workshop. So workshop on a client from morning 11 o'clock to 7 o'clock. So if workshops can happen on a conference, I think it's just a new way of working.
It's so not is a challenge. It, is fact, it business as usual for you despite lockdown?
Business as usual has two parts to it. One is, are we doing media activities and everything together all together or not? No, it's not. That is not business as usual. But client engagement, strategic discussions, plans for future, how do we reboot after the lockdown? All those strategic discussions are on. And that's business as usual with the teams and with our clients, which is very encouraging. So work doesn't stop, day doesn't stop. In fact, that brings me to the second part of your question is how do you keep the team going? And again, big shout out to all the teams, the way they have responded to the situation. I mean, let's put it this way. The most important thing that we all have to realize in this period is empathy. We understand working from home is difficult. We understand we have our daily chores also to do. And hopefully I will send you the photograph that I have to send you. But with all the daily chores that we have to manage, we are with our families, we have kids that are at home who want your attention. You have your pets at home who want your attention and they're jumping into the call. So So all those things managed means how do we work as a pack of wolves is what makes us successful in this period. In fact, what we have done is we are very comfortable with the family members of our teams now. We know all of them now by the end of it. We understand the background noises that are happening. And the best part, what we do is that, like we are doing, we always make sure we all come on video. That's the first thing. We are very used to seeing each other in office, bumping into each other and talking to them. And the moment we realized, the moment we shifted from audio calls to video calls, suddenly the engagement completely changed. We are laughing, we are sharing more, we are talking more, we are expressing more. And everything is taken in a very different spirit the moment we moved into the video calls. So one thing we do is definitely do a video call and not audio one. Second is that we have set a routine. This is a big challenge. I'm sure Naziya, you would have also realized that working hours have completely diluted now.
Yeah.
So 3 days, 4 days into the schedule, we were talking and we continuously exchanged notes. In fact, we have daily check-ins on this one and we are exchanging notes. We realized our schedules are going completely haywire. So we put the clock. We said, this is our check-in time in the day, morning 9:30, when we will do a check-in. And we start the day with a call. All of us come, just laugh it out, set the day, set the routine for the day, what we have to achieve in the day, we do it. And we do a check-out in the day. We again get on a call and we say that, okay, this was the day summary. This is what we have learned. This is what we have to do for tomorrow. Let's not check out and not bother each other because there are many other things.
That is actually a very difficult part of working from home. Then you end up working all the time.
Yes. And we try to do it because we understand there it's not just working from home. Let's remember that we have the things to do at home also. It's no more the same situation where we are just sitting at your desk or going to meetings. We have to manage work at home. In fact, it's completely comfortable when people are blocking hours in the day when they have to cook, and it's there on the calendar. It's like they're cooking, they have to clean, so it's there on the calendar. So it's perfectly fine, and that's something we have to get used to. Our clients are getting also very comfortable with this. In fact, they also have to do it. We are fixing it all. We have our lunch time. So it's quite amazing. We adapted. Human beings are very adapted. So we just adapted to
it. It has also got a human side of all of us out.
Absolutely.
More than being professionals, we've all started behaving more like humans.
Yeah, I think the best part you said is when we also get on a call, I don't think that the first question is, what's today on the business or what's the agenda of the meeting? The first 5 minutes, 10 minutes goes in genuinely asking if everybody is fine, if everybody in your building is fine, your neighbors are fine, are you okay? Especially people who are staying alone.
We are
making sure that we engage enough. Yeah, it's very difficult because there are a lot of people from out station who are staying alone, or for that matter, somebody in their relative. I'm one of the senior leaders in my group. Her husband is actually at a parents' place, which is not far away. Means like Thane versus Mumbai kind of a story. But the movement is not there now, so she's locked alone. And it becomes very important for us to take care of this kind of situation. This is also part of the new challenge that has come our way.
So all the positive things that you are trying to do and trying to keep the momentum on, we are still all worried about economy. We are all worried about the industry.
Yes.
And you're already making recovery plans for your clients, right? What are the kind of worries or what exactly is on the mind of the client right now? What are the kind of things they're coming to you for?
Okay. I think the first thing is that mind reading is out. We are very, very transparent to each other. Because that's the best thing we have learned in this period. Best to be very transparent and upfront. Clients understand the challenges we will face in our business. We understand the challenges we are facing in their business. It's a fact. With the lockdown and the supply chain broken across most of the clients' businesses except for essentials, even essentials are facing problems. It's not that essentials are very readily available. The first and foremost priority is actually to take a decision, media comes later. Versus that, is your distribution is in place? Is your retail supply chain in place? Is it not? I hope everything is in order. If it's not worth spending. It's a very, very clear discussion. Let's protect, because this money can be utilized later also. What we are talking to our clients and more is that we have seen when in past globally some pandemics have happened, or for that matter World War II, we have learnings from there, or for that matter what we are seeing now experiencing in China. And we are learning continuously from our Wavemaker office in China, from Italy, from all. We as a group are very connected and we are sharing a lot of notes. What we are realizing is what I am calling it as renewed consumerism. The moment people are stepping out of the lockdown, there's a spurt in actually spending. Consumers are stepping out, refueling or spending even in luxuries, because it's like hope triggered purchase, let's put it this way. So they are actually stepping out and doing more shopping. So it's an opportunity on the other side of the lockdown. When you step out of it, there's actually opportunity, and therefore
it has played a role on our psyches, you know, in the sense we're all stressed up somewhere. So we will all want to go on a holiday or do something once this period is celebrated.
Yes, absolutely.
So that is where you think the brands will gain again.
Yes, absolutely. There will be a momentum the moment you step outside the lockdown, and we are putting plans in together. So what we are doing to actually help our clients reach there is not just locally, but as Wavemaker as a network, we have put together an entire plan. Like we have weekly webcasts where all our clients are joining in across the globe, and we are sharing what we are learning from China, Italy, or for that matter from London now or Germany. So we are sharing a lot of information because it's giving us a kind of a head start what to do. So like yesterday there was a specific discussion happened. Then we are also putting together papers on global plus India, how each category movements are right now. And then after lockdown, what are the predictions that we are seeing? Not that any prediction will make sense, but whatever best we can make out of this piece is we are trying to put together a plan. Means that when we come back, we are not without a plan. We should have a plan. This is a completely black swan event. We can do nothing about it. But when we come out on the other side, we have a plan. That's very important. And that's something which we are working with at now.
ARC has released numbers show that viewership has increased. I mean, which is of course expected because we are all locked in our houses and watching televisions. So there is an increase of almost like what? News genre has increased by almost 298% growth. 298% growth in news, and business news has increased by 180%, and overall television consumption has gone up by 37%. Does this give some hope to advertisers? Do you think this, with these numbers, they can try advertising even despite of lockdown and other things, just for building brand trust or brand value? Yeah. Are you giving these kind of suggestions to the brands?
Let me put it in this order. This is how our recommendation to the client is. Yes, there's a massive sitting audiences which are there to be tapped. It's not just TV that you're seeing this trend. Even we are seeing this trend in OTT. We are seeing this on news apps online. So there are online, if you see news now, we are getting the data 1 week later now. So and we anticipated it. It's not a surprise. We anticipated this. However, on a daily basis, we have been tracking a lot of online platforms. Even online platforms are showing almost like a holistic graph. That's the kind of growth we are seeing there on a daily basis. So it's not something which we didn't anticipate. So we knew that is going to happen. People have more disposable time. Maybe not us, we are continuously on our meetings, but there are people with more disposable time. So we anticipated it. However, this is something which we have to understand. Is my business as usual on ground? Is my distribution and my retail distribution, retail, or for that my supply chain is in place. Am I there in the market or not? If I'm not, then the money spent may not result in any business. Unless you are a brand or a category who's trying to create a disproportionate share of mind in this time. It's a great opportunity for all the brands. That's how we are bucketing it out. Brands with very strong equity already, but a broken supply, we are asking them to preserve and wait for the other side. But the clients who are looking for disproportionate share of mind at this point of time, because it's a low clutter period also. Most advertisers are also cancel campaigns. It's a fact, we know that. So,
also, have the rates gone down? Ad rates have gone down?
We have not engaged on this specifically.
Okay.
So there might be opportunities, but we have not engaged on it as yet on this one. But definitely, there's a case where the clutter is low. So if an advertiser wants to gain a disproportionate share of mind, and especially if you are a native online or a tech com, you have an opportunity, genuine opportunity to leverage it, because low clutter plus you are online, served online. So there's
Do you have clients who are using this opportunity?
Yes, there are. So for a lot of CPGs and the usual TV advertisers who have come down, there are others who have stepped in. Others
what
who have stepped
sectors
in and who are
would these be?
Bulk of it will be what I will call it as tech firms. All tech companies.
Okay, tech
companies. All tech companies. Let's put it this way. Bulk of it is by tech companies who are doing it. Other places, there are advertisers whom we are engaging. This is the first opportunity on that lens. Other pieces that there is a great opportunity for brands who may not be there in the market to actually tell very genuine stories. And that's something which we are engaging very actively with our brands. There are brands across whom we are engaging, and we'll start seeing it in another week's time or maybe another 2-3 days time. We'll start rolling out. What we are doing is how we are producing content sitting out of home. How we are bringing in basically talents together who are basically also working from home and producing genuine content which is of value to consumer. You have to be, it is not brand speak. It is purely how we can improve consumers' life in this point of time when they're locked inside their home. And that's a genuine story. In fact, we have done only an inciting work around that. Our Wavemaker content team has, in India and globally, have worked on an insight piece on what are the genuine fears and triggers on which consumers are sitting on. And opportunity may not be the right word to use, but can a brand genuinely improve their life when they are operating from such constraints in their life? So that's something which we are also working on. So definitely, three pieces is that there are categories who are still able to fulfill essentials plus tech who are stepping in and actually advertising at scale. Then there is a huge content story. And third piece is also e-commerce. A bit right now, e-commerce is disrupted in last 1 week's time because of the mandate on only supplying essentials and etc. But we are tracking e-commerce delivery on an everyday basis. And we are sharing that with our also clients. As their supply or distribution of e-commerce comes back on track and they keep opening zones, and we are seeing it, tracking it on every day, we are stepping up again e-commerce as an advertising option. As those platforms, it's like brands advertising on e-commerce and also thereby gaining from that. So that's another piece which we are very aggressively working on a daily level.
Shekhar, you told me that you're tracking markets that were affected before us and now they are back to business. For instance, China. What are the kind of learnings that you've got from there? And we don't know how long the lockdown in India may go on. We don't know how far are we from resolving this crisis. But where do you see India as comparison, if you compare it to China or other markets that have suffered from the similar crisis and now back on track, getting back on track?
we definitely see China as a great example whenever we are on the other side of it. What happened with China is that they skyrocketed with the entire epidemic, and then also with the complete lockdown and strict rules, they came the numbers also came tumbling down. I think I'm very happy with the efforts that the government is taking today, because we went into a lockdown much earlier than many other European countries. We went into it much earlier. So hopefully, if we don't be stupid and we follow all the rules, we may not be that badly impacted what we are seeing on in Europe and all. So fingers crossed that we behave responsibly and we are not stupid. Having said that, what we are definitely seeing from China is that what first thing that we talked about, there are a lot of categories, including luxury cab categories. They have started buying like anything. We are seeing almost, yesterday on a call only, and we got a sense that most of the sectors are recovering at a speed that is unbelievable. And they may, some of the categories are back to almost 70% of their original numbers. So that's the kind of speed at which the recovery is happening in China. We are seeing this. And we definitely have a lot to learn from it. Basically, it is that we have to be prepared. We cannot suspend work. We have to make plans and keep it ready for the day where we get locked down. I don't know when we'll actually get over in India. I don't think so. 15th April is a realistic deadline, the way the numbers are moving right now. We might be in a lockdown longer than that. That's what we are seeing from most of the markets also. But what it says is that that we should not stop communicating to our consumers simply because they are also looking for coming out on the other side. And and it's very important we don't break their habits. Means we are in a 21-day lockdown. Typically, 21 days is what it takes to break a habit or a make habit. We should not break their habit of the brands they are used to also. So there's a merit talking. Continue talking and be prepared with a very strong plan when you come out on the other side.
So does that mean that if the lockdown continues for a longer period, some advertisers may again start advertising?
Absolutely. It's impossible for us to stay off air that long. What will happen is that, again, lot of categories and brands actually work top-down on a marketing funnel, which is like building awareness that drives consideration, but followed by this thing. If we not continue, and that's something which we are also actively talking to our clients in our, how as a Wavemaker we plan is the consumer journey, which is having a strong priming bias leads to a great active conversion. If we're not going to advertise, the priming bias for your brand in the category will come down. And that priming, typically a brand with a higher bias, priming bias almost converts 9x versus the brands which don't have 9x time better conversion versus the brands don't have priming bias. So it's very important that we don't lose that. Another thing is that let's also understand there's a lot of brands and categories have a season coming up. Season have no relevance in this kind of a situation. However, still June and July onwards, there's a lot of season thanks to a lot of brands leading into festive. And a lot of brands start building momentum much earlier. Those work will not stop. And work on that is already on. And at the same time, we see that they may not be able to evade it because irrespective, we are not staying in lockdown that long. So we'll have to start building upfront.
My last question is about your final words that you would like to, or a piece of advice that you would like to give to youngsters who are still new to this domain, this business, and they're stuck at home. They do not know what to do. They need direction from you. Yes. So what would you want to tell them?
This is something which we are actively doing internally also.
But not just Wavemaker. This is for the industry. Yes.
I know what you're saying, and I genuinely thanks for the opportunity to talk to all of them because I genuinely believe that this is a tough time, unprecedented. None of us have ever experienced it. It's a lifetime of experience. Think about it like that. Have you ever thought for so many days we'll stay at home? Means that in itself is a very different thing. We have not experienced anything like this, and we'll never experience something like this in our life.
Hopefully.
But what if, yeah, hopefully, yeah, definitely. I'm very positive that we're not going to be doing it. What we are generally talking is that to all our people internally and to the community as a whole, is that don't fall off the grid. That's my first request to you. All the individuals, it's not the best time that you think that you can actually get into the bed, cuddle inside of under your blanket and live the life. Stand at your window, look outside, see the world. The sun rises every day. The day is beautiful. The birds are chirpy. In fact, the dogs are enjoying the streets more than they do usually. So it's
pollution
a bright
levels
day
have
outside.
Come down.
Pollution, yeah. A bright blue sky. I posted a photograph on my Facebook a few days back. I've never seen such a beautiful sunset ever. So, and that's from my balcony. So it's amazing. So there's a lot of positive things around. So don't get bogged down by this thing. Second is that definitely don't participate in WhatsApp groups which are talking a lot about the negativity. It's perfectly fine if you switch off. Perfectly fine. Look at the positive side. Engage with the positive news. Don't get so caught with all the forwards that are happening. 50% of them are fake. The ones which are genuine might have already come to you through any of the news app or newspaper, so or on news channel. Trust them and not on those WhatsApp forwards. Third is set up a routine. Start on a time, finish on a time, and for the routine, make sure you get up and get ready. It's a very important part. We both are, like, for example, ready on to be on a call. It's very important that get ready for the day. Get up, wear a nice clean t-shirt or shirt, dress up, sit on the table, do video calls and not this thing. And second is have fun. Just as a group gather together, all those people you used to hang out with, used to go for your smoke break, none of them are there. So just use Zoom, use Microsoft Teams or Skype, and just have fun together. And exercise. It's very important you exercise. It triggers a lot of positive energy. And that's something I'm talking every day to my team also. Another is something which we are generally trying to do is include your family. It's perfectly fine. If you don't have your family around, especially take care of them, because the people who are alone, please take care of them. They are all your friends. Another thing is, it's a perfect time to lose bad habits. You may not be able to step down for your smoke breaks. Lose them. Lose those bad habits. It might be a blessing in from a personal health point of view. These are basically the points I'm leaving with, all of the things. And finally, the last bit is that it's my personal experience. What I want to also share is that I never felt so connected with my team or with my clients ever before. It's an amazing experience. We are talking more, we are engaging more, we are getting on video calls more. We are much more closer than the normal times. It's amazing. It's amazing, a bit ironical, but I've never felt so close with them, because we are engaging that many times in a day. We're getting on a call. There's a common joke, long time we have not seen you. It's a common joke that we every time say when we get on a call. So these are all also the positive side. So we should see the positive side and enjoy it more. Do some great work as we are in quarantine. Explore the fields that we have not explored at all till date. And the final bit of advice, train. It's the perfect time to upskill yourself. There are enough and more training modules. If you don't have, ask your management for those training modules and go on training. Go for rigorous training. Not everybody has the same workload. So go for rigorous training, upskill yourself. It's a huge opportunity to upskill yourself. That's my last bit.
Thank you, Shekhar. Thanks a lot for joining us. Stay at home and stay safe.
Stay safe, Naziya.
Thanks. See you. Bye.
Bye. Bye.